Hello guys, this is Riya Katyar. I'm a third year undergraduate student in the Department of Civil Engineering at IIT Kanpur. I hope you are doing well and keeping safe at the same time. As the internship season 2021 beheads us, I hope you are preparing well. So I interned at MasterCard as a data engineer in summers 2020. And I'm here to give you some preparation tips on which areas you need to focus more on and which areas you need to focus less on. So without wasting any time, let's just begin. So the first thing I wanted to mention is your resume. So imagine that you are given just 1 minute to describe who you are, why are you worthy for the role you are seeking. So that would be difficult, right? And a resume has an idea very similar to that. So you need to accommodate as well as give appropriate weightage to all your accomplishments in your resume. So believe me, recruiters just require 1 minute glance at your resume to judge whether you are fit for the job they are offering or not. So for your resume, be selective as well as be inclusive at the same time. Do attend the CV making sessions that different cells are organizing for you. And also do get your resumes reviewed by multiple seniors. The last part is I'm going to lay more emphasis on, because many of us hesitate to show our resumes to others, but it's really important, and getting your resume reviewed will highlight a lot of mistakes that you are making that you may not know of by yourself, as well as it would refine your resume to the best level possible. The second step is the recruitment test. So there are multiple kind of tests like aptitude tests and programming tests, psychometric tests, analytical tests that the companies hold, and in many instances it is a combination of all these. So the key to cracking these tests is not one but many. So I'll begin with competitive programming. So it's a very important skill, and almost 90% of the companies hold a programming test for their selection process. So I would advise you guys to devote 2 to 3 hours daily in competitive programming. And for the websites, I would like to suggest, I used CodeChef and Geeks for Geeks. So the beauty for Geeks to Geeks is that it offers you sample questions from real interviews and tests, so you get a better perspective on what is the difficulty level of the questions that are asked. Now the don'ts here. So I've seen many people just revising the concepts of C or any other programming language for 10 to 15 days before starting competitive programming. So I would like to advise to refrain from that and just begin practicing. You'll learn the syntax as you go, and I'm sure you all have done ESC 101, so you have a basic in programming. Also, do not revert back if you are not able to solve questions at first. Begin from a basic level, from level 1, and then proceed slowly on to further levels. Also, do not solve questions with your friends. You can ask for help if you are stuck somewhere, but solving questions in teams would give you a drawback as you will be alone in the real test. The second aspect is time. Many of the aptitude and vocabulary tests are timed, and you need to solve 40 to 60 questions in like 40 minutes or in like 1 hour. So the average speed should be from 30 seconds to 1 minute for one question. The questions are easy and may seem very obvious at first, but when you sit down for a mock test and when you solve those questions, then you'll notice that the expected time is at first high, and you'll have to improve upon that. So I'll encourage you guys to solve mock questions on websites. I tried to give you the links of the websites that I used, but there were many and I could not find the links. So just go on to Google and you'll get a handful of websites that offer these trainings and mock tests for people to practice. Also, you'll need to continue with this until the real tests begin. So I'll encourage you to not devote more than 1 to 1.5 hours on this daily, because then you'll finish off very early and then there will be a big gap and you lose this skill over time. So yeah, proceeding on to the third aspect of preparation is if you are sitting for a analytics or say for a machine learning role, then it's most probable that you will be asked questions on probability, machine learning concepts, etc. So I would recommend you to do online courses. I used Coursera for doing some of the courses I had interest in, and now that the institute has a tie-up with Coursera, you can avail those courses for free and it has become very easy now. So I could provide a link of the courses that I've done, but I would like you guys to explore by yourself and go on to the website, search for courses that interest you, read about them and select courses wisely. So I can give you the list, but do not use it as a restriction on the domain of the areas you can do courses in. So you can ping me and have the list, but I would not like to restrict you guys by giving some list of courses, particular list of courses, because what I believe is that exploring is more beneficial in this area. Also, never ever complete courses just for the sake of it and just for the certificate, or you need to mention the course in your resume, because this will be very harmful. These questions are asked in tests as well as interviews, and it would be really beneficial if you do it with all your heart. Moving forward to interviews and shortlist, most of the preparation needed for interviews includes the one for the tests, and some additional points I would like to add are have mock interviews with your seniors as well as your friends. Practice coding questions from a perspective that you can write the pseudocode and explain the approach to the interviewer. Also, be prepared with interesting answers for the general questions, as you'll have to express the best version of yourself in an interview. And it is really necessary because the interview is the most crucial part of the selection process. So one advice that I have here is that since things are going on, as you know, virtually, so last year also there was a company that had an interview, for instance, and in that interview you could hear only the interviewer's voice, and the interviewer could have your voice as well as your video. So that created a very difficult situation, as we almost practice for face-to-face interviews every time we think of interviews. It would be face-to-face or audio-to-audio as we perceive it. So as things are more uncertain this year, I would like to advise you guys to practice on this as well. An additional preparation would be for guesstimates. So I didn't knew about it until my first interview, but this is a very crucial part of a interview for an analytics role. So guesstimates are basically designed to test your analytical skills based on an assumption and calculation framework. So for guesstimates, it's also the same. You can just go on to Google and practice guesstimates with your friends and know the right approach you can have to solve questions. There's nothing as a right answer or a wrong answer to a guesstimate. It's only there to test the approach that you have towards problems. So for an interview, you need to be real, be confident, and be the best version of yourself possible. Now I would like to answer a few questions you guys had from your end. So the first question is, do we need to focus more on competitive programming or ML/data science? So my answer is both. You need to focus on both these fields to prepare for an analytics role, and it would be a drawback if you are lagging behind on any one of these fields. So proceeding on to second question, it's the importance of data structures. So data structures is not completely necessary for a data analysis role. So you just need to have the right approach towards problems, towards programming problems as well. And I did not myself do a data structures course, for my internship. So yeah, the third question. Is it necessary to have experience in different software packages if you have basic knowledge of concepts? So it is good to have an experience in using one or two software packages, and it would hold an advantage. If only knowing the concepts would do, then the whole idea of practical application would lose its essence. So yeah, try to explain, try to apply your learnings on practical real world problems using some software packages. So the next question is, which institute courses to focus on for this field? So it's very important that to make sure that you have done some course on probability and statistics like HSO 201 or MSO 201, and if not, it would be highly recommendable if you can do an online course, because there are many questions and tests as well as interview from this field. Also, you can revise the courses which had some analysis projects, and you can mention these in your resume under course projects, or also you can highlight these things in your interview. So moving on, I am recording this video on 30th May 2020 and I have just completed my internship yesterday. So it was a great experience, and the organization made sure that in spite of the fact that the internship was virtual, we stayed connected and were at the peak of our interaction. We had so many sessions, starting from what the company does to technical sessions as well. It was a great overall experience for me. The projects were well planned for the duration, and the team members were really supportive. The future prospects in this field are very high, as the exploration on the power of data never ends. And if you have the acumen for analysis and drawing conclusions, then I would suggest that you'll really enjoy this kind of role. Also, something I learned from my internship experience, from the application process until the completion of the internship, was that never stick on to questions like this is the only role I want to do, or this is the only opportunity that I want to have. So you'll have to be open to changes, you'll have to be open to exploring new opportunities, being acceptable to all the great opportunities that come your way, and try to extract the best out of what you have today. I try to accommodate as much as possible in this short video, but if you have any questions, major or minor, then you can ping me anytime. I'll be really happy to help, really happy to clear your doubts. All the best for your preparation. Happy learning.